The rainstorm did a lot of that.
Dear compatriots, it has become necessary for me to address you on the recent spate of terrorist activities and protracted security challenges in some parts of the country, particularly in Borno, Yobe, Adamawa, Gombe, Bauchi, Kano, Plateau, and most recently Bayelsa, Taraba, Benue, and Nasarawa states. These unfortunate events have led to needless loss of lives and property of many innocent Nigerians, including members of our security forces. The recent killing of security operatives by a core group in Nasarawa State is particularly condemnable. They have directed that no effort or expense be spared in identifying and bringing to justice all those who had a hand in the killing of the operatives. The activities of insurgents and terrorists have been reprehensible, causing fear among our citizens and a near breakdown of law and order in parts of the country, especially the North. We are taking robust steps to unravel and address the root causes of this crisis, but it would appear that there is a systematic effort by insurgents and terrorists to destabilize the Nigerian state and test our collective resolve. Since I returned to the country after cutting short my visit to South Africa and aborting a planned state visit to Namibia, I have received detailed briefings from our security agencies. These briefings indicate that what we are facing is not just militancy or criminality, but a rebellion and insurgency by terrorist groups which pose a very serious threat to national unity and territorial integrity. Already, some northern parts of Borno State have been taken over by groups whose allegiance is to different flags and ideologies. These terrorists and insurgents seem determined to establish control and authority over parts of our beloved nation and to progressively overwhelm the rest of the country. In many places, they have destroyed the Nigerian flag and other symbols of state authority, and in their place hoisted string flags suggesting the exercise of alternative sovereignty. They have attacked government buildings and facilities. They have murdered innocent citizens and state officials. They have set houses ablaze and have taken women and children as hostages. These actions amount to a declaration of war and a deliberate attempt to undermine the authority of the Nigerian state and threaten the territorial integrity. As a responsible government, we will not tolerate this. Previously, we adopted a multi-track approach to the resolution of these problems through actions which include persuasion, dialogue, and widespread consultation with the political, religious, and community leaders in the affected states. We exercise our strength to allow for all efforts by both state governors and well-meaning Nigerians to stop the repeated cases of mindless violence. Yet, the insurgents and terrorists seek to prevent government from fulfilling its constitutional obligations to the people as they pursue their fanatical agenda of mayhem, mass murder, division, and separatism. While the efforts of persuasion and dialogue will continue, let me reiterate that we have a sacred duty to ensure the security and well-being of all our people and protect the sovereign integrity of our country. Therefore, we shall on no account shy away from doing whatever becomes necessary to provide the fullest possible security for the citizens of this country in any parts of the country they choose to reside. We have a duty to stand firm against those who threaten the sovereign integrity of the Nigerian state. Our will is strong because our faith lies in the indivisibility of Nigeria. Following recent developments in the affected state, it has become necessary for government to take extraordinary measures to restore normalcy. After wide consultations and an exercise of the power conferred on me by the provisions of Section 305, Subsection 1 of the Constitution of the Federal Republic of Nigeria 1999 as amended, I hereby declare a state of emergency in Borno, Yobe, and Adamawa states. Accordingly, the Chief of Defense Staff has been directed to immediately deploy more troops to these states for more effective internal security operations. The troops and other security agencies involved in these operations have orders to take all necessary actions within the ambit of their rules of engagement to put an end to the impunity of insurgents and terrorists. This will include the authority to arrest and detain suspects, the taking of possession and control of any building or structures used for terrorist purposes, the lockdown of any area of terrorist operations, the conduct of searches, and the apprehension of persons in illegal possession of weapons. The details of this proclamation will be transmitted to the National Assembly in accordance with the provisions of the Constitution. But in the meantime, let me make it clear that within the purview of this proclamation, the governors and other political office holders in the affected states will continue to discharge their constitutional responsibilities. I urge the political leadership in Borno, Yobe, and Adamawa states to cooperate maximally with the armed forces and the police to ensure that the exercise succeeds. We call on all citizens to cooperate with our security agencies to ensure the return to normalcy within the shortest possible time. I'm again approaching our neighboring countries through diplomatic channels as done in the recent past for their cooperation in apprehending any terrorist elements that may escape across the border. Nigerians are peace-loving people. These sad events perpetrated by those who do not wish us well have not changed the essential character of our people. I want to reassure you all that those who are directly or indirectly encouraging any form of rebellion against the Nigerian state and their collaborators, those insurgents and terrorists who take delight in killing our security operatives, whoever they may be, wherever they may go, we will hunt them down. We will seize them out, and we will bring them to justice. No matter what it takes, we will win this war against terror. I'm convinced that with your support and prayers, we shall overcome these challenges, and together, we will restore every part of our country to the path of peace, growth, and development. Long live the Federal Republic of Nigeria.